What if you had a plug-and-play system for quickly turning your video ideas into killer YouTube content? A Notion template to manage your videos and systemize everything you learn about YouTube into a video template that you can repeatedly use and modify over time. This system will speed up the time it takes you to get your first 10,000 subscribers and save you countless hours every single week. As always, you can find the template as the first link in the description. Now let's get started. My first question to you is, who are you creating content for? Can you define your perfect subscriber? If not, then you need to go to the bottom of the YouTube workflow and fill out the perfect subscriber page before doing anything else. Take your time and define your perfect subscriber as clearly as possible. The more clearly you can define your perfect subscriber, the easier it will be to come up with good video ideas. Which brings us to the next section. When it comes to YouTube, there are three key elements that you need in order for your video to go viral on your channel. The first element, and also the most important, is the video idea. Even if the video is good, nobody will click on a bad video idea. A good video idea will make everything you do a lot easier. You can keep track of all your video ideas inside the ideas view, where you can sort all your active video ideas at the top using this checkbox. You can also add in details like the video's folder number, the video topic, and the publishing date, which will make it show up on the calendar view. Then you also have the status property, which is what this database is filtered to, allowing you to move all your completed videos to the videos view, where you can add in the URL after the video has been published. So how do you find good video ideas? Well, there are plenty of ways, but I'll just quickly go through one of them, which is through competitor analysis. If you go into your YouTube analytics to the audience tab, you'll be able to see what channels and videos your subscribers are watching. You can also open up an incognito window and search for content in your niche and just start clicking through a bunch of different videos and see what YouTube recommends you. And probably the most effective way is to use a tool called vidIQ to do market research and see what people are searching for in your niche. And if you have the Chrome extension installed, you can go to your competitors' channels and see which of their videos are getting the highest views per hour, which is usually a good indication of the type of content that your niche is currently interested in. The second key element for a good YouTube video is the video packaging, aka the title and thumbnail. You should spend as much time, if not more, on your title and thumbnail, because what's the point of creating a video if no one is gonna click? If you want your channel to blow up, then you need a high click-through rate. So how can this Notion template help you with your video packaging? Inside of Notion, when we open up our new video, you'll see we have a section to plan out pretty much every part of our video. But for now, we'll just be covering the title and thumbnail. Inside the title ideas toggle, you can write down all of your different video titles. Your title should be the single most intriguing idea and the reason people would watch. Inside the resources section, you'll find a tool called Headline Analyzer, which you can use to help you create better titles. Never use a title with a score below 70. Try multiple versions and angles until you get the title in the green. You can scroll down and see some suggestions and use their word bank to help you craft a better title. Before moving on to the thumbnail, write down at least 3 titles with a score above 70 so you can ask people for feedback, test your titles, and change them out if they're not performing well. And now for the thumbnail. If you go into the thumbnail page, at the top you'll find a guide with all 8 thumbnail strategies, plus some other thumbnail fundamentals that are really important to know. Back on the main page, you'll see the thumbnail formula with the 3 key elements for any good YouTube thumbnail. It needs to visually grab people's attention, be relevant to your viewers' interests, and create intrigue so they want to click to satisfy their curiosity. Next, you will find a table that helps you define your video packaging. There's also a toggle to plan out each of your 3 thumbnails, because just like with the title, you need at least 3 in order to get feedback, split test, and have a backup in case your thumbnail gets a low click-through rate. At the bottom, you have a checklist for both the thumbnail and the design, a table to add feedback from others, and a section to paste in your MillerNote link. You can use MillerNote to visually compare your different thumbnails. First, you want to add your thumbnail and title to thumbsup.tv to preview how it will look on YouTube. Then take a screenshot of the first preview and paste it inside your new MillerNote board created for your video. Repeat this for every version of your thumbnail to compare them side by side. To get the board link, click on share in the top right corner, copy the link and paste it into Notion either as a bookmark or as an embed. Another useful tool is called Thumbnail Check, which allows you to preview your thumbnails on the YouTube homepage next to other videos. By the way, all of the links to the tools mentioned in this video can be found under the resources section inside the video template. In case you want to personalize and make changes to the video template, then all you have to do is just click the drop down next to new and edit the template button. The idea here is that you would start off using this template and over time adapt and personalize it to fit you and your channel. And the third key element of any good YouTube video is storytelling, which includes the hook, story, and offer. After making them click on your video, you actually need to get them to watch your video. If you're an educational channel, you don't necessarily need to use storytelling. You can get away by just providing value. However, learning the fundamentals of storytelling will allow you to quickly make the viewer understand why the thing you're teaching is important in the first place. And regardless of what niche you're in, there are multiple retention techniques that you can use, which are all conveniently integrated into the toggles here on the script page. Inside of the script page, you'll find two toggles at the top, as well as a toggle for the video hook, story, and offer. Inside the avatar toggle, you can define your video from the perspective of your viewer, and you can use the brainstorm toggle to figure out why they would keep watching the video. If you want to add your own questions, simply create a callout box set to the default color with an icon and the text at the top in bold. In the description below, I'll leave a link to my full Notion guide and aesthetics tutorial in case you want to learn more about Notion. Next up, we have the hook toggle. Inside this toggle, you'll see we have a couple of sections, starting with the first one, where you need to put on the viewer's hat and go through the viewer's journey to understand what they want to see in the beginning of the video. Then you have a section for listing out incentives to include in the video, so the viewer will watch till the end. And then you also have a section for the content of the hook itself. And at the bottom of the hook toggle, you'll find a checklist that you can follow to make sure you've got the winning hook. Then for the story toggle, you again have a section where you need to put on the viewer's hat and define what the viewer wants to see in the video. You have a section to define what the viewer needs to do, feel, and know in order to take action and see results. You got a section for the loops that you will open throughout the video to keep them engaged, a section to define how you'll build the relationship between you and the viewer, and a section for planning out the transformative storytelling the viewer will experience throughout the video. And the last toggle is for the offer, aka the thing you'll be driving traffic to at the end of the video. It can be another video, a product or service, your email list, etc. And this offer toggle is there to help you define your call to action. After going through all the toggles, it's time to script the video. Start by writing down the most important points you want to discuss, and then just keep writing. If your script is getting long, then you can use the toggle headings to keep everything organized. And to plan out the visual elements, you can simply add text after a sentence describing how it will look visually and make it bold and change the color. You can color code certain types of visual elements, like for example, stock footage is blue, B-roll is red, animations are green, etc. And if you have a video editor, then make sure everything is clear and concise, so you don't need to explain anything and can just share the script. To share your video script, just go to share in the top right and either invite them to your YouTube workflow or click publish and share the script link. After writing your script, you would record your video, which doesn't require Notion, unless you're making a video about Notion like me, but more than likely you just use your script as reference or to follow some bullet points. Once you've recorded and edited your video, it's time to schedule it, do keyword research, and split test your titles and thumbnails. While you're still in the planning phase, you can already include all the important links, description information, and keywords inside of the toggles, so when you're busy scheduling, you can just copy and paste everything into the video. And when it comes to keyword research, I'd recommend using VidIQ. You want to find relevant tags that has a high search volume and low competition. And if you have the Chrome extension installed, you'll be able to see your SEO score out of 50. Always aim to get a score of at least 45 out of 50 by using the maximum amount of relevant tags and including important keywords in your video title and description. After scheduling your video, it's time to split test the video titles and thumbnails. To split test, you can replace your current thumbnail or title with a new one after 48 hours or after 7 days to see which one performs better. Alternatively, you can use a tool such as Thumbnail Test to split test your titles and thumbnails in real time after uploading, and you can log all of the results into the split test page inside of Notion to track the stats for the different thumbnails and titles. Inside this YouTube workflow, you might have also noticed there's a roadmap database. You can use this database to plan out the projects you want to complete and the goals you want to achieve for each subscriber milestone. When it comes to YouTube, you need a goal to start, but you need consistency to finish. YouTube is difficult and will require a ton of focus and time, but if you can master YouTube as a skill, then you will have forever solved your traffic problem. As you saw, this Notion template will massively shortcut your YouTube learning curve and save you countless hours every single week. If all this template did was decrease the time it takes you to reach 10,000 subscribers, would it be worth it? If so, then be sure to grab this template through the first link in the description and make sure to watch this next video if you want to become a Notion Pro in less than 20 minutes.